Вы слушаете SBS Russian.
Вы слушаете SBS Russian. Мы отдаем дань уважения традиционным владельцам земли, их старейшинам прошлого и настоящего. Приветствуем вас в очередном выпуске нашей постоянной рубрики Learn English. Для тех, кто учит английский язык, хочет совершенствовать свой английский и особенно его австралийский вариант.
Learning English helps me communicate better with a hairdresser.
Hi, I'm Josipa. For me, going to the hairdresser isn't just about getting a new look. It's like a mini vacation for my soul. A chance to kick back and enjoy some pampering. To kick back means to relax. And to pamper someone or yourself is to do pleasant things for them or to them, to make them feel good and relaxed. I love it when someone pampers me by fixing my hair and maybe bringing me a coffee while I relax in the chair. Do you? I have a friend who doesn't like being pampered, but honestly, if I could, I'd get my hair done every day. Just imagine, a perfect hairstyle every single day like a film star. But it's not cheap to go to the hairdressers, so most of us can only dream about doing it daily. And it's not just the girls. A lot of guys I know care just as much about their hairstyles. Now, here's the real reason I'm doing this episode. My last trip to the hairdresser was a disaster. Because I couldn't understand the names for different hairstyles. I felt intimidated, shy, silly, and a little scared. So, as a result, I ended up with a hairstyle I didn't like at all. I don't want that to happen again to me or anyone else. So today, we are going to practice some phrases we can use when we are getting a haircut. Ready? Then let's see what's going on with Claire and her son, as they are both about to get haircuts.
So, what are we doing today?
For him, just a fade. Something textured on top, so it's easy to maintain.
No worries. And for you?
I'd like a bob, just above the shoulders.
Okay. Are you thinking a layered bob or a blunt bob?
Oh, I'm really not sure. What do you think would suit my face better?
Well, I think layers would frame your face nicely. And if we do that, we can get rid of the split ends.
That sounds good. What about a fringe? Do you think I could pull it off?
Absolutely. A soft fringe would look great on you.
Do you see what I mean? This kind of conversation can be tough when you don't know the words in English. But don't worry, I'll explain everything. By the way, when talking about a haircut, we can just say a cut. And Claire first said that her son wants...
just a fade, something textured on top, so it's easy to maintain.
A fade cut, which we can call just a fade, is when the hair on the sides and back is cut very short, but it's left a bit longer towards the top of the head. Texture in hairstyle means how the hair looks and feels. And if your hair is textured, it has layers that are uneven, making it look a bit messy rather than smooth. So it's easy to maintain. That is, it doesn't need a lot of time or effort to keep it looking good. So Claire's son likes the textured fade because he doesn't have to do anything to it when he gets up in the morning. But let's say you want your hair to be very, very short on the sides and much, much longer on the top, so that the long hair falls over the sides and back. Then you could say,
can you give me an undercut?
There are different ways to do an undercut, but the key idea is long hair on top and buzzed sides. To buzz the sides is to cut the hair very short using clippers so that it almost looks shaved. And in fact, if you want to look like a soldier from an action movie, you could say,
can you do a buzz cut for me?
A buzz cut is when it is extremely short all over the head. When my brother started losing his hair, he switched to a buzz cut because he said it was easy to do himself with hair clippers. Have you got hair clippers at home? They're a small machine with blades that you can adjust, a bit like a big shaver, and you can cut hair very short with them, very quickly and easily. Hair clippers. Now, do you remember what type of hairstyle Claire has in mind for her cut? She said,
I'd like a bob, just above the shoulders.
A bob is a haircut where the hair is cut to the same length, usually to about level with the chin, or sometimes a bit longer to the shoulders. It's a classic and easy-to-manage style that works well for a lot of people. There are different ways to style a bob. For example,
are you thinking a layered bob or a blunt bob?
In a layered bob, the hair is cut into a bob shape, but with different lengths or layers. This adds texture and volume, making the hair look fuller and more dynamic. On the other hand, in a blunt bob, the hair is cut to the same length all around, with no layers. For example, Margot Robbie, Beyoncé, Jennifer Lopez, Rihanna, Taylor Swift, and many other celebrities have all had a blunt bob at one time or another. But for Claire, our hairdresser Alan thinks,
layers will frame your face nicely, and we can get rid of the split ends.
When you have layers framing your face, your hair is cut in different lengths around your face, and this makes the features of your face stand out. Alan also said,
we can get rid of the split ends.
Split ends are my worst enemy. They're tips of the hair when they have been damaged and so start to split. Let's say you have beautiful long hair and you don't want the hairdresser to cut too much off. You just want them to tidy it up and get rid of the split ends. Then you can say,
I'd like a trim, please.
In a trim, the hairdresser only cuts off a small amount of hair in order to take off the split ends or make things level, without significantly changing the overall length or style. But be careful because, in my experience, hairdressers just love cutting and sometimes they can get carried away. To get carried away is to be so interested and involved in what you are doing that you forget to stop. At the end of our dialogue, Claire had a question, or two.
What about a fringe? Do you think I could pull it off?
To pull something off means to do something successfully. So, if you pull off a new haircut, it means you look great with it. Let's hear Alan's answer.
Absolutely. A soft fringe would look great on you.
A fringe is a section of hair that is cut so that it falls over your forehead. And it can be long or short and styled in different ways, such as straight on the side and so on. Sometimes people refer to a fringe as bangs. I first heard the term bangs in American movies, but it seems it's becoming more common in Australia as well. So we can use both, a fringe or bangs. Now, let's listen to the dialogue again and practice the phrases from this episode. Whether you're going for a big change or just a trim, the hairdresser's chair will be a place where you can relax and be pampered.
So, what are we doing today?
For him, just a fade, something textured on top so it's easy to maintain.
No worries. And for you?
I'd like a bob, just above the shoulders.
Okay. Are you thinking a layered bob or a blunt bob?
Oh, I'm really not sure. What do you think would suit my face better?
Well, I think layers would frame your face nicely. And if we do that, we can get rid of the split ends.
That sounds good. What about a fringe? Do you think I could pull it off?
Absolutely. A soft fringe would look great on you.
My colleague from SBS Punjabi, Jasmeet, is one of the coolest people in the office. She's always very stylish, especially with her turban, which she pulls off like no one else can. She has a warm, friendly smile that makes you feel good even from across the room. Hi, Jasmeet.
Hello. Oh my gosh, such an introduction. Lovely introduction. Thank you so much for having me here.
Thank you so much for coming. So, when I was talking about a potential guest for this episode, Rosa, the editor of Australia Explained, mentioned that you've never cut your hair. Is that true?
How long is
your hair?
That is true, but I have a bit of a disappointing answer for your second question. I don't have hair that's too long. It only comes up to about my waist or hip area, and that's because I actually have curly hair and like ringlet curly hair. And a lot of the length gets shortened because it's curly.
So it's long up to your waist and curly?
And curly, yes.
Oh my God,
that's
it's
right.
Beautiful. Like a princess.
So it is long. I have a lot of friends who have really long hair and they also have kept it for, you know, since we're born, we don't cut our hair. And they have really long hair and really long straight hair and I'm always jealous of them. But yeah, I have curly hair that comes about up to my waist.
So can you tell me a little bit more? I want to learn about your culture. Can you tell me a little bit more about why in your culture you don't cut your hair?
Definitely. So I think I was born into a family that was a very heavily practicing Sikh family, and we belong to the Punjabi culture. Now, when I was born, it was just given that I was going to grow out my hair and I was going to follow all the principles that my parents followed. But when I grew up, you know, I wanted to know more about the why. So I had been practicing this. I had never cut my hair. I started covering my head to school when I was about in year two. But it was just all a given. There was never an answer to the why. So when I did go around and do my research, and as per my understanding, we don't cut our hair because we believe this is how God created us. This is how we were naturally created. So we embrace our natural beauty and we don't alter it. We don't change it. And that's why we grow out our hair. And to take care of our long hair, one of the greatest ways that was suggested contextually was to cover our hair with a turban or any other head covering. So you might see different types of turbans that someone that identifies as a Sikh ties. And all the different styles are all just personal preference. All the colors are also personal preference. But it's to take care of our long hair that we naturally grow after we're born. Another reason why we tie the turban is for a symbolism of equality. Now, if we look at it in the context when the Sikh religion was up and coming in the 1600s, 1700s, around that time in the Indian society, only rulers or people of royal descent were the ones that tied turbans, and it was associated with being of a highly respected person in society. And our religious teachers, who we call our gurus, they wanted society to be founded in equality. And to push the message of equality, they were like that all of the individuals that follow this practice or everyone should be treated the same. So the uniformity was brought about with the turban.
That's so beautiful. I love it. Can you help us learn some phrases that we practiced in this episode?
Yeah, sure.
It's time to practice. See if you remember the meaning before hearing the answer. What is pampering?
Pampering means taking extra care of yourself to make you feel good and relaxed.
What does it mean to get carried away?
To get carried away is to be so interested and involved in what you are doing that you forget to stop.
Now, let's repeat after Alan and Claire.
Can you give me an undercut?
I'd like a fringe, please.
Can you do a buzz cut for me?
I'd like a bob, just above the shoulders.
On our website, we have prepared learning notes for this episode. sbs.com.au/learnenglish. You can also learn with us through our Facebook page. We are SBS Learn English. I'm Josipa. Thank you for learning with me.
Хотите услышать больше таких историй? Это можно сделать через Apple Podcasts, Google Podcasts, Spotify или в любом приложении для подкастов.